Hi everyone, in this video I'll show you how to create, run and manage queries using NVivo. In the previous video, we had completed the coding using the interactive coding process. Queries provide a flexible way to gather and explore subsets of your data. NVivo queries offer a flexible approach to exploring and analyzing your data. You can create quick and simple queries to get a sense of what's happening in the data, or you can build detailed queries for a more focused perspective. I will show you how to create queries in NVivo by defining the criteria yourself. You can save the queries that you create in NVivo and run them again as your project develops. Keep in mind that qualitative analysis is exploratory in nature, so there is no way we know in advance which queries should be best ones to use. We'll have to try out different queries, examine the results, and select appropriate ones to present in the report. In this process, we need to keep in mind our research questions and research purpose. The queries should provide us with results to answer those research questions. Based on what we can decide whether we need to run additional queries or stop, we do not want to underdo it, which produces underwhelming outputs that do not allow us to find the answers. On the other hand, we also do not want to overdo it, which will result in too many queries that are overwhelming, disconnected, and confusing. Again, the key question is, do we have enough results to answer the research questions? We'll cover some simple queries in this video and get into more complicated one, metric coding queries, in another video. One useful query that we can run quickly for all codes is hierarchy charts. Go to Explore tab in the menu and select hierarchy chart. It gives us a quick overall picture of our codes for all nodes. As you can see, the tree map shows all parent nodes and percentage of all child nodes in a hierarchy format. The size of the bar represents the percentage of the code for each node. For example, in this case, we can say that we have more positive attitude than negative one. Similarly, there are more people experiencing work pressures than time requirements. If you choose sunburst, it shows us the same information within the pie chart format. In my opinion, this format is harder to read and understand than the tree map. You can make changes to the hierarchy chart to show different information. For example, if I want to see the information of the attributes, I will select attribute values for cases and then select age and gender for the query purposes. Let's say I want to sort codes by gender first. I move gender up. NVivo classifies data by gender first, and in each gender, it shows percentage of age ranges. What if I add discipline to the list as well? Now we have more breakdown of the data by those attributes. It's a very useful tool to get the whole picture of the codes. Again, we should not overdo it, as it will make the results harder to understand, thus less useful. We can also use this tool to show the codes by cases. We'll select coding for files, and NVivo presents the codes by participants. For example, Elizabeth has the most codes, followed by Frank and Andrew. On the other hand, Douglas has the least codes. Let's use another useful query, coding query. Go to Explore Queries and select Coding. We can define any criteria to find the needed results. We can choose any if only one criterion should be met, or we can choose all if all criteria should be met. We just need to be careful not to create too many criteria that might result in no outputs because the criteria cannot be met. Let's try some examples. For example, I want to run a query to find the codes for benefits within the source or science discipline only. I click this arrow and select benefits node. Now I want to add another criterion, so I click the plus sign. For this one, I select any case where and select an attribute. I choose discipline. The discipline should be social science. So I choose equals value and social science. Click run query. Here's the results. The reference tab shows the actual code, the text that met those criteria for each person. If you select summary tab, we will see the quantitative results. Here are the number of references and the percentage corresponding to all participants that met those criteria. One thing you might notice is that it's missing in the Mac version is a quick chart. In the Windows version, we have an option to see the same results, but in a bar chart. We can do that with just a click because it is a built-in feature. Unfortunately, the Mac version does not have that feature. You can, of course, copy the data to Excel and create the bar charts as well, but it will take some extra step. Let's review another query, cross-tab query. It is a very versatile query that allows us to run many different analyses based on our need. It provides a quick way to check the spread of coding across cases and attributes. As mentioned here, cross-tab queries produce cells representing the intersecting coding between codes and attributes of codes and cases. You can also color the cells to differentiate them. I will select some specific nodes for this example. In this case, I will add two nodes, attitude toward being a researcher and benefits. Then I will select two specific attributes for the comparison. I will select person for classification and choose age and discipline as attributes. I run query. The results are classified as by age first. And in each age range, we can have different disciplines. Explained before, in the Mac version, we do not have a built-in graphing feature, but we can color code the table. To do that, we'll click the results tab on the far right. We see different color schemes. I will choose this one. Now we can see the same results, but with different color codes for easy viewing. If your query has returned interesting content, you might want to save it for reviewing later. To do that, we just need to click Save Results and type the name and select Save Results. If you want to save the query criteria, then select Save Criteria, type the name and click Save Criteria. To access the query results, we need to go to Explore menu on the left, select Queries and select Query Results. We should see the results we saved here by double-clicking it. Similarly, to see the saved criteria, we select Queries under Explorer and select Query Criteria. We should see the criteria we saved here. That is how to create queries using NVivo. Thank you and bye now.